11th July, Saint Benedict, Abbot, Memoria. Born at Norcia in Umbria about the year 480. After studying at Rome, he led a life of solitude in Subiaco and gathered disciples around him, and then went on to Monte Cassino. Here he founded a well-known monastery and wrote his rule, as a result of which he has been called the father of monasticism in the West. He died on 21st March 547, but from the end of the 8th century, he has been venerated on 11th July in many places. A reading from the rule of Saint Benedict. Let them prefer nothing whatever to Christ. In the first place, when you begin something good, you must beg of the Lord with unflagging prayer to bring it to completion, so that He, who has already been so gracious as to count us among His sons, will never be saddened by our evil deeds. In fact, at all times, He should be so served with the good things He has given us, that not alone will He never, like an angry father, disinherit His children, nor yet as a dread Lord, angered by our misdeeds, hand over to everlasting punishment the wretched servants who did not wish to follow Him to glory. Let us stand up on our feet then, for Scripture rouses us, saying, "It is full time now for you to wake from sleep." And having opened our eyes to the light of God, let us listen attentively to what the divine voice cries out to us daily. Today, if you would hear His voice, harden not your hearts. And again, he who has ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. And what does He say? "Come, my children, and hear me, that I may teach you the fear of the Lord. Run while you have the light of life, lest the darkness of death overtake you." And the Lord, seeking for one who will work with Him in the crowd, to whom He cries these things, says again, "Who is he who longs for life and desires to see good days? If on hearing that you reply, 'I am,' God says to you, 'If you wish to have true and everlasting life, keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking deceit. Turn aside from evil and do good. Seek and strive after peace. And when you shall have done these things, my eyes shall be turned to you and my ears open to your prayers. And before you call upon me, I shall say to you, 'Here I am.'" What could be dearer to us, brothers, than this voice of the Lord inviting us? See how in His love the Lord shows us the way of life. Girding our loins then with faith and the observance of good deeds, let us so follow His paths under the guidance of the gospel, that we may be worthy to see Him who has called us into His kingdom. If we desire to live in the dwelling place of His kingdom, there is no means of reaching it except by the way of good deeds. Just as there is an evil, bitter seal which cuts us off from God and leads to hell, so there is a good seal which shields us from vice and leads to God and eternal life. This is the kind of zeal, then, which monks should exercise with fervent love. That is, let them be eager to show honor to one another. let them bear patiently their infirmities, whether of body or character. Let them vie with one another in mutual obedience. Let no one follow what he judges advantageous for himself, but rather for another. Let them love the brotherhood in all chastity. Let them fear God in love. Let them love their abbot with sincere and humble charity. Let them prefer nothing whatever to Christ, and may He lead us all alike to everlasting life.